At least 7,875 Nigerian doctors are currently practicing in the United Kingdom, according to the UK's General Medical Council. The General Medical Council, which is the government body that maintains the UK's official register of medical practitioners, also says India, Pakistan and Nigeria are the countries with the highest number of doctors practicing in the UK. The website of the UK Medical Council on Thursday evening showed that the number of Nigerian doctors working in the UK had risen from 7,870 to 7,875 in less than a week. The Council's revelations generated reactions on Thursday from the Nigeria Labour Congress, the Nigeria Medical Association and the National Association of Resident Doctors. Now, according to the statistics obtained from the UK Council's website, Nigeria is the African country with the highest number of doctors in the UK. Dr. Pascal Ezekoye, medical practitioner, joins us now from Saudi Arabia to share his thoughts on this. It's a pleasure to have you join us. Thank you very much. Now, the recent report published has shown that more doctors are leaving the shores of Nigeria to practice abroad. What do you attribute this to?
Thank you for having me. Actually, there are so many factors that are resulting in the mass exodus of doctors from Nigeria to overseas. We can classify this as a governmental and non-governmental factors. But basically, let's look at the governmental factors, one of which are poor enumeration of doctors in Nigeria. It might interest you to know that the least doctor or the least cadre of doctor in Nigeria, which is a medical officer, the salary of this cadre of doctor in Nigeria, which is a medical officer, is nothing to write home about. But the same caliber of doctor in Saudi Arabia or United Kingdom, his salary is higher than that of the highest cadre of doctor in Nigeria. A medical officer in Saudi Arabia earns almost $1 million+ in a month, while a consultant in Nigeria, which is the highest level of doctor in Nigeria, doesn't earn up to that in Nigeria. So what do you expect them to do? Now, aside the remuneration, there are a lack of infrastructure, facilities, and basic amenities which these doctors require to work. It might interest you to know also that most of the hospitals we have in Nigeria doesn't have the basic apparatus which you require to resuscitate or save a life of a patient. And I don't know how you can be saving a life of a patient with just your bare hands. Just in this pandemic, most of the doctors we are complaining, they don't have even the PPE. That's the ordinary gloves, the hand gloves, the gown they need to wear in order to protect their lives so as to be able to save patients.
Why do you think
these things are provided to you on free basis? You get it at your peck and call. You don't even need to ask for it. They're all available in the hospitals.
Pascal, why do you think that even now, with the pandemic and the reality, even a government official once said that he didn't realize the rot of infrastructure in the health sector. What is going on and the high need and high demand for doctors now in Nigeria? Why do you think the government is not being as proactive as they should be in response to the needs of these doctors?
Why they're not being proactive is that those at the helm of affairs in the Ministry of Health, which are our senior colleagues, are also part of the problem. A minister of Health once said that he doesn't know the function of a doctor in an airport. What does that tell you? If somebody that is at the helm of affairs that determines the policies that is going to help to champion the lives or save the lives of Nigerians doesn't know the function of a colleague in an airport, doesn't know the cost of the hazard allowance of a doctor, what does that tell you that is happening in the ministry? A former minister of health once said that doctors can become a tailor, doctors can become a farmer. There is something you need to understand. When you are not being appreciated in your environment, when your country doesn't value you, what do you do? You go to an environment where you are valued, where you are appreciated. You can't be more patriotic than an unpatriotic government. Those are the helm of affairs. The Minister of Health, the Commissioners of Health, they are all doctors. They are the ones responsible for the problems, the systematic failure in the health sector. So let's not apportion this blame to the politicians. They are part of the problem. Okay? Now, it might interest you to know that some of the doctors in Nigeria, okay, let me give you an instance. A friend of mine who happens to be the best graduating doctor in the postgraduate exam that was conducted in West Africa in 2015, West African College of Obstetric and Gynecology, couldn't get employment in Nigeria. But the same guy is working in Saudi Arabia presently, and he's earning over 2 million naira a month. So what does that tell you? Now, the government denying that they don't know what is happening shows that they are incapacitated, they are incompetent, they are not meant to occupy the positions. They only are those positions to enrich and loot the funds that are meant to help to save the lives of the Nigerians.
What now, can the Nigerian people do? Because earlier today, I spoke with a doctor, the chairman of NMA in Ekiti State, and they are currently on strike over issues of salary, hazard payments, and all of that. What is there a role here for the people of Nigeria to, you know, rise up in defense of these doctors so that better attention can be paid? Is there any role for the Nigerian citizen in this matter?
The truth is that the Nigerian citizens are incapacitated. They don't have much to do in order to be able to revitalize or restructure these things. Most of the problem lies with the government. Most of the job lies with the government. It's the government that is going to revitalize this sector. It's the government that is going to restructure this sector. It's the government knows what to do. The current Minister of Health trained in Germany. So yeah, he also practiced in the United Kingdom before relocating to Nigeria. He should ask himself, what is happening in Nigeria? Is it what is obtainable in the United Kingdom now? Is it what is obtainable in Canada? Now, the only thing the masses can do is to protest. And the truth is, with the present government in Nigeria, protest does not lead to anywhere. Protest cannot even help, because the government doesn't even care about the masses.
Stop then maybe the doctors. If we talk about the long-term implication of these situation of having our doctors leave our shores for greener pastures, maybe that will propel some sort of action. So please, if you can, in 30 or 40 seconds, talk to us about the long-term implication of these continued exodus of Nigerian doctors to foreign countries.
Okay, the long-term consequences is that, one, there is going to be a massive brain drain because we are losing our expertise. We are losing the best hands to overseas countries. Then, two, the lives of Nigerians will be at the mercy of God. We only rely on churches first, because if a common teaching hospital in Nigeria don't have an ECG, a machine which is required to check your heart, which in general hospitals in overseas, they are found in general hospitals, there are defibrillators. And a doctor died in Bayelsa, a medical doctor died in Bayelsa some time ago because there was no defibrillator in the hospital. But in overseas here, you have defibrillator in every general hospital, top of tertiary hospital. So the consequences are enormous. It's not something you can talk within 30 seconds. But what I'm trying to say is that with what happened in pandemic, which now the rich men are also experiencing is many of them died because of the poor infrastructures in the hospital, because they refused to fix up the hospitals. Now they are bearing the consequences. So those consequences, if that can happen to the rich, what will happen to the poor? So the only thing I can say is that for now, let's not think of how to checkmate those doctors in Nigeria from leaving, and not how to woo those outside from coming, because you can't tell somebody that has experienced heaven to come back to hell. If you happen to travel outside this country and see what is happening and see the kind of life, you will never want to go back to hell to practice. Thank you.
All right, Dr. Pascal Ezekoye, thank you very much. But Nigeria is not hell. Why are you saying Nigeria is hell? But thank you anyway. We get what you're trying to say. Thank you. And be safe out there.
All right, thank you.